Добро утро на всички, добре дошли. Изключително сме щастливи, че сме заедно с вас днес в тази зала и ще говорим за любимата тема за всички нас, които ни виждате тук, Reinventing Organizations. И ще имаме възможността да се срещнем с изключителни презентатори, да научим интересни неща. Надявам се, че за вас ще бъде един много вдъхновяващ ден, много интересен и пълен с преживявания. Аз съм Таня Бояджиева и съм един от съорганизаторите на това събитие. Искам специално да кажа две думи за всъщност основния ни организатор и вдъхновител и човека, който стои зад стартирането на тези конференции Reinventing Organizations, Биляна Георгиева, която, за съжаление, поради здравословен проблем не е в състояние да присъства днес. Но искаме наистина да й благодарим много-много дълбоко и от сърце за това, което тя прави, за това, че ни вдъхновява, че ни събира. Тя също е и новия председател на STOS Network България, Асоциацията за иновативен менеджмент в България. Така че да започнем с едно голямо браво за Били и с ръкопляскания за нея. Така ще дам думата на следващата ми колежка, която е съорганизатор и това е... всъщност не. Извинявам се.
Аз мога директно да се включа. Приятно ми, аз съм Вихра и така като се случиха нещата, аз всъщност вчера се включих към организационния екип. Но за както и нещата стават да се включваме с това, което е и да бъдем в това, което е. Но аз всъщност искам първо да видим и да създадем малко една картина на това, кои сме ние тук в залата. Затова ще има малко движение, но не и прекалено много. Ще ви помоля, първо, това е събитието, което се случва за втора година. И знам, че някои от вас са присъствали също така и миналата година. Тези от вас, които са били тук на Reinventing Organizations 2016 година, може ли да ви помоля да станете? За да видиме. Благодаря ви. Също така бих искала да помоля всички участници днеска тук, които са от България, да се изправят. Благодаря ви. А сега бих помолила също така и нашите чуждестранни гости да се изправите и да покажете къде сте. И благодаря много, че сте пропътували дълги разстояния, за да бъдете тук. Искам също така и да добиеме малко представа на това от какви сфери сме се събрали тук в залата. Затова ще помоля първо хората, които са от IT сферата, ако могат да се изправят също така. Благодаря. Също да кажа, ако се идентифицирате с повече от една сфера, сте добре дошли също така да ставате колкото пъти искате. Хората, които са в сферата на услугите или се идентифицират с тази сфера. Сферата на услугите. Благодаря. Хората, които са в сферата на производството. Сферата на образованието. Хората, които се идентифицират с друга сфера, не спомената от тази, която... Да. И моята покана към всички вас е също така да се огледате хората около вас, хората на вашата маса, кой къде, кога е ставал също и да използвате възможността да опознаете също други хора в тази много различна и смесена група, която сме тук. И събрали сме се от различни сфери, от различни държави дори. Но сме се събрали също така с нещо, което ни обединява. И с това аз давам думата на Зорница, която ще ни каже повече за фокуса, който ще имаме през днешното събитие.
Благодаря, Вихра. Благодаря, че ни раздвижи и ни запозна. Това, което ни обединява днес, въпросът, който си зададохме, за тази годишната конференция и който поканихме вас да си зададете и да участвате заедно с нас в търсене на отговора, е как създаваме ангажираща работна среда с фокус върху решенията. И днес сме поканили хора, които ще ни дадат различни аспекти, различни размисли, така че да можем да се опитаме да си отговорим на този въпрос и да се опитаме да си набележим първи стъпчици, които да ни помогнат да създадем ангажираща среда в нашите организации. Каним ви да участвате активно в дискусиите, които предстоят, и за да подсигурим всъщност пространство, в което дискусията може да тече постоянно, използваме една платформа, която може би някой от вас познава. Това е Slido. Отстрани на панелите имаме закачен лист с линка към тази платформа и с номера на стаята, в която може да се вържете и да задавате въпроси. Вашите въпроси ще бъдат видими за всички. Ние ще ги следим и ще можем да дискутираме заедно с нашите гости това, което ви провокира през деня. Освен това, искам да добавя благодарности, освен към тези хора, които сме тук сега, и към всички останали хора в залата и около залата, които работят с нас, за да създадем това пространство. Това са нашите хора с графичния запис, нашите приятели с видео и фото, репортаж от събитието, нашите преводачи. Искам да кажа, че Лили, която е един от нашите преводачи днес, празнува рожден ден, така че честит рожден ден, Лили! Както и на хората, на доброволци, които се включиха, за да ни помагат, за да ни съдействат и партнират през целия ден и преди събитието, така че да можем да сме тук и да го създадем. Сред нас е и нашия мистериозен гост. Вие знаете, че имаме един гост, който решихме да не откриваме. Вашето предизвикателство за днешния ден е да разберете кой е нашия мистериозен гост. Преди 5 без 20, когато ще го открием официално. И сега започваме да говорим за промяна и целият ден ще бъде насочен към тази тема. Искам да дам думата на Лея, която ще ни разкаже една кратка история.
Добре дошли от мене. То за мене нищо не остана да кажа. Аз знаех, че ще бъде така. Знаех си, че ще бъде така. И затова реших още на идване насам да ви разкажа един много кратък разказ за промяната. И той се казва «Да хванеш голямата вълна». «Catching the big wave». И става дума за госпожа Слончева и за господин Маймунски, които седят на морския бряг и се наслаждават на залеза. Господин Маймунски бута госпожа Слончева и каза, виж, там в бурните води има един пловец. Той мах след мах се мъчи да дойде към нас, към брега и всичко това му струва огромни усилия. Така се случва промяната, бавно, с огромни усилия. Госпожа Слоницата нищо не казва, след минутка бута с крак господин Маймунски и казва, господин Маймунски, виж, там има един сърфист. Той е хванал точната вълна, тази вълна, която ще го доведе до брега и гладко, плавно се носи в бурните води към нас. И все пак промяната може да се случва лесно и бързо. Това е разказа, който лесно и бързо и гладко ни приплъзва към първия панел от нашата програма. И аз ще ви оставя в ръцете на Марк Макъргъл и на Гергана Дженкова. Марк ще дойде тук в момента, само да ви кажа две думи за тях. Марк Макъргъл е нашия гост от Обединеното кралство или по-точно от Шотландия. Той е мислител, философ, оздравяващ физик, човек, който ражда идеи, привежда ги в действие, великолепен практик, коуч, обучител, автор на книги и вдъхновител на много хора по целия свят. Гергана е човек тук, много близо до нас. Тя е също коуч и е консултантка и работи с хора, когато те имат нужда да бъдат измъквани от заплетени ситуации. Марк, you're welcome.
Nice. So, good morning, everybody. I hope everyone who doesn't speak English has your headphones on. Thank you. Somebody will start my slides in a minute. So, wonderful to be here. As Leah said, I come from Scotland, and we arrived on Monday for this visit to discover that Bulgaria has gone tennis crazy. So I come from Scotland, and Scotland has a lot of things in common with Bulgaria. It's a similar place in many ways. In Bulgaria, you have rakia. In Scotland, of course, we have whiskey. In Bulgaria, you have a lot of music, particularly including the bagpipes. In Scotland, we have music, including the bagpipes. In Bulgaria, you have Grigor. In Scotland, we have Andy. So, I'm going to spend 20 minutes talking about working with change. Working with change. And this is going to be a big picture thing, but with some practical ideas too. And then we're going to we'll have a discussion and a panel afterwards. Let me start with this thought from my work in Solutions Focus. Change is happening all the time. That's a working hypothesis when we work with Solutions Focus ideas, which is a methodology that I found in therapy, and I've brought into organizations. Change is happening all the time. That's our starting assumption. And then the simple way to change is to find useful change and amplify it. Find useful change and expand on it, do more of it, amplify it, make it bigger. Apologies for the translator who's had to find four ways to say the same thing. Sorry. So this is our starting point. Change is happening all the time. As Leah said very briefly, I am a consultant for 30 years, an author, a writer. I used to be a physicist. I'm now a recovering physicist. Not quite better yet. One day at a time. But I've always been interested in this question of complexity and intractability and how an uncertainty and ambiguity. And so what I'm going to say today, I say from an organizational perspective and also from a physics perspective. I think this is true in physics as well as it's true in organizations. And I've written several books. You see them there. I'll talk about a couple of them as we go through particularly. So, question for you. Is the world basically like this? A clockwork thing which can be adjusted, changed, mechanically altered, finely tuned? Is the world like this? Or is the world more like this? The guy in the kayak, where things are swirling around, there are forces that we cannot control, but we nonetheless, we have a little influence with our paddle. Huh? Now, what do you think? Is the world like this, the clockwork world, which some physicists used to imagine? Or is it more like this? Well, I'm going to share with you this morning 5 myths about change. And these myths come from people who believe too much in the clockwork model. And we're going to see how each of these myths can be busted and what we can think instead that's much more useful if we're interested in helping to build change in organizations and people. So here are our 5 myths that I'm going to bust this morning. Change is hard and unnatural. That's the first myth. People want you to believe this. Particularly change management consultants want you to believe this. So you pay them a lot of money. Right? The second myth, change has to be made to happen. I don't believe that's right, and I'll tell you why. Third myth, change means doing something different. Maybe it does, but not always. And in particular, this is not a necessary assumption. The fourth myth, change needs a plan. I don't think that's true. There are some other things that are much more important than a plan. And fifthly, change must be led. I don't think that's quite right. Or if it is right, we need to change what we mean by leading and leadership. And I'll tell you about that too. So these are our 5 myths, and I'm going to bust them one by one for you on this very stage here this morning. So let's start with the first one. Change is not hard and unnatural. It's happening all the time. I just assumed that in the beginning. Yay for me. So here's the thing. Fun? Excuse me. Thank you. Jenny, my wife here in the audience. So, change is happening all the time. And this is an old idea. So many of you will be familiar with the Greek philosopher Heraclitus, who made this statement that everyone quotes now without understanding it too much. You can never step in the same river twice. Who's heard of that idea? Yeah, you can never step in the same river twice. He's right, of course. You can't step in the same river twice. But most people, when I ask them, why is that? They say, because the water is changing. The water is flowing. What Heraclitus really meant was, you can't step in the same lake twice either. Because even if the water has not changed, you have. Even if the water has not changed, you have, because you now have a wet foot. So this change is not something that happens out here, it happens out there, and it happens in here too, all the time. And this is our assumption. So this guy here, actually, he's a Hungarian performance artist, I think. He's standing in the river to demonstrate how high the river level is. But he is experiencing very much this idea of not being able to step in the same river twice. So the learning point, the takeaway point from this idea that actually change is happening all the time is relax. You don't have to start the change. It's happening all the time. It's okay. Whew. That's a good piece of news to start the day with, isn't it? So, second myth. The myth is change has to be made to happen. Actually, change, if change is happening all the time, it's there to be noticed. It's there to be noticed. And of course, if we don't notice change happening, then maybe we're not sure if it is happening or not. So this is the great idea about this. If we want change, we should start to look for it, and then we should notice it. And when we notice it, we should point at it. Look, there's a piece of the change we want. And you see on the picture here, some of these two guys in the front, they've noticed something. The lady on the right, she's noticed something. The people in the other side, they haven't yet noticed anything. Yeah? So for them, they haven't seen the change happening. So it's one thing to believe that change is happening. It's another thing to equip yourself to go out there and notice it and point at it. So you confirm you see it and you draw attention of other people to it as well. And this is, I go to so many meetings of organizations who say we want to have a change program, and they sit there and they're not noticing any of the change that's happening already. It's crazy. So the lesson is open your eyes and point when you see some of the change you want to have happen going on already. The third myth, change means doing something different. Actually, often, usually, the seeds of the change you want are already there. The seeds are already there. I work in this field called solution focus, and the first book I wrote about it. It's out there in many languages now, not sadly Bulgarian yet. But in solutions focus, we have this way of asking people a question like this. Imagine a scale from 1 to 10. And 10 is where everything you want to have happen is happening already, and 1 is absolutely none of that is happening already. Scale from 1 to 10. Where are you right now? And what do people say usually? 3. They don't say 1. They usually say something like 3 or 4, sometimes even 6 or 7. And what this this tells me that actually some of the things they want to have happening are already happening. So we should look at how that happens and notice how that happens and how to build on that. It's really extraordinary. So the seeds of what you want are already there if you start looking for them. And once again, if you take the, oh, I'm not going to notice anything view, you won't see them. But if you start to point and look and notice, you notice the seeds of what you already want. So noticing what's useful is a key thing. Noticing what's useful. Not noticing what's unuseful or pointless, but noticing what's useful to you. The fourth myth. Change needs a plan. If change is happening all the time, then what happens to your beautiful plan on day 2? It's out of date. Maybe not critically, but it's out of date. On day 3, it's more out of date. On day 10, it's quite out of date. On day 30, it's way out of date. And when the annual meeting comes around, it's ancient history. So here's a better idea. You don't need a plan. What you need, apart from an idea of where you want to get to, is some small steps, some first steps to get things moving right now, next day or two. And very often the situation is a bit like this picture here. Here we have the first steps, and they're leading off towards the light. But we can't see the rest of the journey. We can't see the whole way. We can't see the ladder to the final goal. That's life. That's life with change happening all the time. So one of the things we have to get used to is this idea. We can't see the whole staircase, but we know the first steps and we know they're going in the right direction, so we should take them now. And so the idea of taking some next steps is really crucial. A step that you take and you implement makes much more difference than a big plan that you don't implement. And I've seen many organizations with wonderful plans that somehow they never got around to implementing. So, the lesson, take some first steps. And finally, our myth of change must be led. If change is happening all the time, I think we need to change our conception of leadership. So in the clockwork universe, we have the idea of the hero leader who knows everything, makes the decisions, has the most experience and can make the right decisions for everybody, the hero leader at the top of the pile. And that's okay if the situation is very stable and very well known. But actually, if we take the assumption that change is happening all the time, then nobody can know everything. Nobody can have all the information. And then even if they do, it goes out of date immediately. So the new model of leadership is leading as a host. Leading as a host. And a host is somebody who gathers people together around a complex collective problem. So the model is not a pyramid with a man at the top. Usually it is a man. The model is a circle, but with a host gathering people around and helping everyone to interact, to explore and develop ideas around the complex collective problem. And of course, as they do that, they all change, the problem moves on, and so on. So this is a whole new thought about leadership. And I'm very pleased to be able to tell you that my book on this subject, Host Leadership, is just been published in Bulgarian. And there's a stall outside. The publishers are here with copies of the book at special bargain rates for the conference. And if you want to get hold of a copy, I'm, of course, very happy to sign it if you wish. So the message here, change can't be led, but it can be hosted. So gather people together. Gather people together and begin to work. Because you can't never complete this work. You can begin to work together in a good way. And that's the role of the leader in the new world, I think. So, let's just summarize where we've been. Here are our five new thoughts about working with change. Change is happening all the time, so relax. Change is there to be noticed, so open your eyes and point at useful change. The seeds are there already, so look around for what might be part of the solution and not part of the problem. Take tiny steps to build progress and begin to climb the ladder rather than try to have the plan for getting all the way there. And finally, change can be hosted, so gather people together in very much the way that we're doing today and start to think about things together. So those are my five ideas for working with change. And I hope and expect that as we go through the rest of the day, you will see different elements of things connected with these ideas coming to the fore, and we can think about them in new ways together. So just in conclusion, if you want to find out more about me and Solutions Focus, there's books, there's websites, there are solution-building international groups like SolWorld and Sphio, and feel free to contact me. Of course, I will be here all day. If you would like to come and have a talk with me about any of this, I would encourage you to do that. But for now, enjoy the rest of the day, and thank you very much indeed. Thank you.
Many thanks, Mark. Now, Girgana, there will be a question and answer slot after Girgana has finished. So you can begin. Това ти трябва, да? Господи, аз ще тук ще застана и ще правя.